Roger has heard it all. He's a bartender. People like to talk to Roger, tell him what's on their mind. Memories pile up, minute by minute, one on top of the other, turning the mind into a trash heap, reducing the experience of now to, well, to just another memory. Is that all there is? Oh, to let go. What harm could there possibly be in that?
That guy never comes to meet you anymore.
Who?
Well, the quiet one who used to come in just for closing time and order tomato juice.
Nope.
You lost interest, or did he?
It was a little bit more complicated than that.
And not my business.
Right.
You want me to check the doors?
No, I'll do it.
Oh, I'll rinse those glasses for you.
Oh, thanks.
Going out the back or front?
Front.
Me too.
Can I give you a ride home?
Okay.
I've been wondering about you ever since I started working there.
Wondering how?
Well, I don't know exactly. You look at some people and you get interested in what's happening inside them. And besides that, you're pretty.
It's just an effect of the light.
I like the effect of the light.
Do you?
Yes. Do you want me to go?
Yes, I guess so.
Can I come back?
Maybe. I don't know. This isn't really my kind of thing, men and...
You mean other women?
No, that's not what I mean.
I don't understand.
Oh, maybe sometime I'll try to explain.
Okay. You're sure you want me to go?
Yes.
That was a good dinner.
Well, you could come more often.
Oh, you see more of me than most mothers see of their sons.
Be careful.
Oh, clean it up.
That was one of the good ones.
Oh, a cup's a cup, Mother.
Oh, that's English-born china.
Not anymore, it isn't.
Don't you have any feeling about it at all?
Well, it's a thing, Mother. It's a cup. You have other cups. If it was your last cup, then it might be important.
Well, these things matter to me.
I know.
Now, I've been thinking about the good silver. And when I'm away sometime, a thief could break in here, and that good silver I got from your grandmother would be the first thing he'd take.
You're going to build a vault for it?
Well, I put it in the trunk of the car.
What?
Well, they'd never think to look there, and they'd have a hard time breaking in.
That's ridiculous.
Well, it's not as ridiculous as losing that good silver.
Well, what would happen if you didn't have that silver? You never use it.
Now, things aren't important just because you use them.
Well, things aren't important at all.
Some things are.
Like what?
Mm-hmm. Like that silver.
Why?
I don't know. It's just because it is.
Well, you don't own that silver, Mother. It owns you. The silver cries out that it's threatened, and you leap to defend it.
You do say such silly things. Here, now, help me finish these dishes. Can I get another of these?
Yeah, vodka and
coke. Please. I should probably go home, shouldn't I?
That's really up to you.
Three drop, please, Roger.
Okay. Vodka.
I think I'll go home.
Here's your three drop, Linda.
Thanks.
Why don't you want to go home?
Because I go home every night. And he's always waiting there. Or, you know, I get home first and I'm waiting for him. Well, not that there's anything wrong with him.
What's the trouble?
Do you live with somebody?
No. Well, not right now.
Troy on ice and a scotch straight up.
Okay. If you see Jerry, tell him we're short of ice.
Okay. So you don't live with anybody. You don't have somebody waiting for you and expecting you. You're the same old face you see every day, and until you can't tell whether you're looking at his face or your own.
Maybe you should leave.
Yeah, that's what I keep thinking. But it doesn't seem to make much sense. I mean, he's a nice guy.
So what's wrong?
Yeah, that's what my friends say to him. And I say it's just like Mount Everest. I mean, he's always there. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, maybe.
See you tomorrow, man.
Yeah.
See ya.
Bye. You got all the tables done?
Yeah. I'll help you with those glasses.
Nah, it's okay. Sit down and rest your feet.
Is Jerry coming back?
No. He asked me to lock up.
Ooh, it was a pretty big night, wasn't it?
It's funny to watch people drink.
Yeah. The more I see people drink, the less likely I am to start.
You ever wonder why they do it?
It creates the illusion of freedom.
I was talking to a woman at the bar tonight who was trying to explain why she didn't want to go home to some perfectly nice man.
Did you understand?
In a way. You want to ride home?
I guess.
Well, I'm done here. You ready?
Yep. Oh, nice night.
Isn't it? Hey. My car's gone. I parked it right here. I'm sure I did.
Usually you park around the corner.
And that's why I remember. I can never get a place this close.
It's not here anymore.
That's a legal parking place. No reason for the cops to move it. Somebody must have stolen it.
It's certainly gone.
Well, what am I going to do?
I guess you'll have to walk home.
Now, you're sure that's where you left it?
Yes, I am. I drove to work, and when I came out, it was gone.
You finished work at 1:30 in the morning?
I'm a bartender.
You drink while you're at work?
No. I was cold sober, and I was with a friend, and she was cold sober, too.
Did you look around the neighborhood? Sometimes people forget where they parked.
Yes, I thought of that. Just in case, I checked all the streets where I normally park.
Okay, I'll put a report in. See if it shows up on the computer.
Look, there isn't any chance that you people towed it away for some reason. It was a legal parking place, but you never know.
We don't just tow cars away for no reason.
Well, maybe there was some reason that I don't know about.
If we've got it, it'll show up on the computer.
I keep seeing the car on the street, but it's never mine.
Why do you let it bother you?
I don't know.
Is it really very important?
Oh, yes, it must be.
Why?
That's what I said to my mother just last week. She was worrying about a broken cup and somebody stealing her silver. And now I'm doing the same thing.
Do you really need the car?
No. And maybe I'm better off without it.
Have you ever noticed how nobody talks about the soul anymore?
Well, what's that got to do with it?
Well, isn't that what you were talking to your mother about?
I don't know. Yeah, maybe.
Mm. You always looked to me like a man who wanted to let go of a lot of things he was tangled up in.
It's nice talking to you like this.
Good.
Well, it's late.
Yeah.
Maybe I should go.
Probably.
You want me to go?
Yeah.
You got the paychecks in here, Jerry?
Yeah. Here you go.
Thanks.
Every week when I give you your check, I expect you to tell me you're quitting.
Why?
It's kind of a dead-end job, bartending. I mean, you look like somebody who'd want something better.
Oh, I like it okay. Gives me time to think.
Think? What's to think about?
All kinds of things. Yesterday I was looking at a diary I used to keep, and I wrote about how I used to go to the zoo every week, and every time I'd see this one animal, how it walked back and forth in its cage, and I started to think how most people's lives are like that, except the cage is a bit bigger. They go to work, they come home, they go to sleep, they get up.
Look, it's simple, Roger. You try to do something with your life. Get out of the cage.
Now, that doesn't seem to be what I'm looking for.
But that's all there is. I mean, you look around, and you see what kind of chances there are, and you grab for them.
If you don't, you're... Well, it's like you say, you're just a monkey in a zoo.
But ambition makes you a monkey who keeps learning new tricks.
That's all there is. Old tricks and new tricks.
No. There's more than that. There's something inside the soul.
Come on. I don't even know what the word means.
Tom MacArthur's getting married.
To who?
That Robertson girl you knew in high school.
I don't remember any Robertson girl.
But don't be ridiculous. I think you even went out with her a couple of times.
I don't remember that.
Well, anyway, she went away after high school, and then she got a job here and moved back.
And she's marrying Tom MacArthur, whoever he is.
Now, you're not going to tell me you don't remember Tom MacArthur.
Yes, I remember Tom MacArthur. Though I don't know why. Well, I better get going. By the time I catch my bus and get home, it'll be late.
Well, why didn't you drive? Is there something wrong with your car?
It's gone.
What do you mean, it's gone?
Stolen, I guess. I came out of work a few nights ago and it wasn't there.
Well, I suppose you left the keys in it.
No, of course not.
Well, how else could they steal it?
I don't know. Hotwire it, I guess.
Did you go to the police?
Yes.
Well, maybe they can find it.
Well, they don't seem very hopeful.
What about insurance?
I just had liability insurance. That won't replace the car.
That's terrible.
Well, I find I can get along fine without it.
Well, that's not the point.
What is?
Your car. Just gone like that? Just disappeared?
Oh, I hardly think about it anymore. I can't even think what it was like to have a car.
Roger, you're late.
I know, I'm sorry.
The other guy had to go, so I had to run the bar and everything else, too.
I got lost.
I mean, you've been finding your way to work for months. How come you get lost now?
I don't know. Maybe because I was walking instead of driving. There's a big apartment building where I always turn, but I couldn't find it. And the next thing I knew, I was in a bunch of streets that didn't make any sense. I was just wandering. Places I'd never seen before. Finally, I had to ask someone for directions.
Roger. I mean, next time you're late, try the sick friend routine. It makes more sense.
It's true, Jerry. I got lost.
Well, why don't you get lost behind the bar for a while?
You want to walk across the park?
Isn't it out of your way?
Not much. I should be careful I don't get lost again.
You can always ask directions.
It's funny how that building seemed to disappear.
Yes.
Things are changing somehow. I seem to be forgetting a lot.
Maybe you're only forgetting what you don't need.
Do you think so?
Sometimes I think that our minds get more and more full of the past until there's no room for things to happen. And nothing does.
So we have to forget things before anything new can happen.
You have to have a kind of amnesia. Then you can be totally present in every moment. A saint.
No memory, no plan.
That's right.
Where did you learn these things?
They're just things I've worked out. Reading, thinking.
For dinner?
Oh, it's nice to have something cooked for me for a change. I've been looking around your apartment. Seems awfully bare.
Well, I've been clearing things out. I want to get down to the things I need.
Roger, where are you getting these strange ideas?
From Linda, I guess.
Who is this Linda?
A friend.
Is it serious?
Well, yes, but not in the way you think. She teaches me things.
I can imagine.
There are things in the world besides sex, Mother.
So what does she teach you?
About what's inside me.
I've never been convinced that there was anything inside me but a lot of soft plumbing.
Inside the mind.
Where's that picture of you in your scout uniform, the one I always liked?
Well, I got rid of it.
Why?
There's no point in living in the past.
You want to pour me about 27 more whiskeys?
How about starting with one?
I'll drink to that.
There you go.
Change.
Thanks.
I'm trying to work up my courage.
Yeah?
Yeah. Get out. Don't run away.
From what?
Everything. Job, house, lot. See, I have this idea that I'd go to the Ark and spend the winter there, all on my own.
You ever done that kind of thing before?
Oh, sure, I've been out there before. Wilderness camping, that kind of thing. Out there, you know what's real.
Isn't it possible to do that right here?
I don't see how.
Just let it all go. Make it not be.
I never went in for magic tricks.
Well, it's only there if you let it be. That's what a friend of mine says.
Hey, the only way it's not there is if I get on a plane and fly it.
Excuse me. Do you know this neighborhood?
Yes, I do.
Isn't there a record store somewhere near here?
I don't think so.
No, I'm sure there is. I bought a record there just last week. It was right beside the florist's.
I've lived around here for 10 years, and there was never a record store beside the florist's.
I was there just last week.
You must be confused.
Are you still keeping your silver in the trunk of your car?
Oh, make fun of me all you like. I still think it's a good idea. Come and look at these photographs.
That whole pile?
No, just these. Where were they taken?
I'm not the person to ask.
Well, you were there. Oh, there you are in the picture, making faces.
Photographs are funny things, aren't they?
Well, what do you mean?
Here are all these funny little gray and white things. And we assume that they show us something that really happened.
Well, of course they do. Now, try and remember where this was.
I won't remember. Forgetfulness is more my style these days.
What do you mean?
Things are disappearing.
Like what?
Yesterday I was looking for a record store. I was in it last week, right beside a florist shop. I talked to a woman who lived nearby, and she was so positive that I was wrong. It was quite funny.
Roger, do you think you should talk to someone?
Why should I do that?
Well, this business of forgetting, things disappearing.
Now, that's only happening because I want it to.
Well, I think you should stop talking to that girl, that Linda.
Why?
She's the one who's doing these things to you.
But I feel good. Everything I see is brighter than it ever was before. Everything I hear is clearer.
I'm frightened for you.
Is it dangerous?
You have to decide that. I can't tell you.
My mother's terrified.
But anyone who locks their silver in the trunk of the car must already be terrified.
Yeah, I suppose.
Are you frightened?
Sometimes I wonder what's going to happen.
Do you want to control it?
Maybe.
And then you end up back where you started.
Well, can't you stop halfway?
Guess you can try.
Excuse me, may I help you?
I'm looking for a recording of Mahler's 10th symphony.
10th?
That's right.
But he only wrote 9.
He wrote 10.
9. Beethoven, Mahler, and Bruckner. They all wrote 9.
I had a recording of Mahler's 10th. I had to throw it out.
It must have been the 9th. There's no 10th symphony.
I'm sure I had a record of it.
A symphony can't just disappear, can it?
Things have been, you know.
Have been what?
Disappearing.
Really?
You got a minute, Jerry?
Sure.
I wondered if you could work the schedule so that I could get a couple of days off.
Well, it won't be easy. What do you need time off for?
I don't know if I can explain it. I'm not sick or anything. I just feel kind of shaky.
Like how?
I can't explain it. It's just something strange is happening to me.
Maybe you should talk to somebody.
Yeah, maybe. Is Linda coming in today?
No, she's off. Has this got something to do with her?
Sort of.
Is she pregnant?
No, it's nothing like that. But I think she'd be a good person to talk to. She seems to understand.
This problem, is it kind of personal?
In a way.
Look, Roger, is this... I mean, do you figure you're gay? Something like that?
No, it's nothing like that, Jerry. It's not that kind of thing. Not like that.
You don't sound very good, Roger.
I'll be okay.
Look, I'll fix the schedule for you. Take a couple of days. Find somebody. Maybe talk it out.
Yeah. Oh, thanks.
When I was young, it was different.
Huh?
It just seemed easier. You weren't so tangled up in all the parts of your life. Maybe it was just the 60s. You know, all that talk about revolution. We all assumed that the inside and the outside fitted together.
Yeah.
I've been going to an analyst, Jungian, and that's what I've been trying to do, is find the key that let me find what's really going on inside me.
Excuse me?
What?
I was listening to what you were saying. I know I shouldn't have been.
Let's move to a different scene.
Yeah. I just want you to know that what you're saying, what you're talking about, it's dangerous, you know.
Why don't we get off of this stuff? You want the beer?
Do you live here?
Yes.
Well, I'm looking for someone.
Who is it you want?
Her name's Linda. I need to talk to her. I think there's something missing in what I've learned. It doesn't seem to be working out right.
Is she some sort of therapist?
Oh, no, she's just a friend. See, I've been losing things. Or forgetting. Or I don't know which.
What's your name?
Well, does it matter?
No, I guess not.
Have you lived here very long?
3 years.
Then you probably know her.
Which apartment is she in?
The basement.
There's no apartment in the basement. Just the furnace and a laundry room.
I was there with her. I'm sure I was.
It must have been a different house.
There aren't any other big brick houses on this street, just apartment buildings.
She didn't live in one of those?
No.
You remember being here?
Yes.
But there's nobody named Linda living here. There never has been, in the time that I lived in the house.
Well, maybe I made a mistake. We work at the same place. I can see you there.
Hi.
I've never seen you before.
I just started here.
Well, I work here too, but I've been taking a couple of days off.
Oh. Well, can I get you something?
Draft, I guess. When did you start?
Oh, just today.
Is Linda here?
Oh, I don't know any Linda.
Well, she works here too.
Oh, I haven't met her. I guess she's not in today.
Things are disappearing.
What?
Well, it's something happening to me. It's nice in a way. Like when I look at your face, it's as if there was a special light on it. It's as if I never saw a face before and I didn't know what it was. So I can really concentrate.
Yeah?
You know, Linda taught me how to do it, how to let go.
How?
I don't know, really. In a way, it just started to happen.
I don't think I really follow what you're talking about.
Oh, would you do me a favor? Would you go and check on the schedule and see when Linda's working?
Sure.
Is Jerry in?
No. I looked at the schedule.
Is Linda working tomorrow?
There's no Linda on the schedule.
What about me? My name's Roger. When do I start back?
Well, there's no Roger there either.
Oh, I see. Well, thanks for looking. I guess I better go. Yes?
Roger, I've been worried about you.
Why?
You didn't come for dinner.
Was I supposed to?
On Wednesday, you always do.
Do I?
What's the matter with you?
Is something the matter with me?
You're looking at me so strangely.
Oh, I'm sorry. I hope I'm not being rude. It's just that I'm wondering why you came to my door.
I came looking for you.
Do I know you?
Roger!
Yes?
I'm your mother. You must remember me. I'm your mother.
Ah, well, now that you've told me, maybe I'll remember you.
Roger, you've got to get help.
Well, I don't need any help, but I'm going out now. Maybe you could visit some other time. Who did you say you were?
Roger!
What's that?
What do you mean?
That! What is it?
It's a streetcar.
And what's that?
What?
What is it?
A store.
And that? What is it?
Is this a joke from a radio station or something?
No, but what is it?
It's a bicycle. You're serious, aren't you? Like this isn't a joke.
What's a joke?
You're crazy.
No, I'm not crazy.
Yeah, what are you then?
I am what I am. I'm kind of a saint. There's nothing in my mind but pure being. Nothing else at all.
Roger got out of the cage all right, and turning around, it was gone. He was free at last of the dreadful captivity of things, memories. He'd have to tell Linda about it sometime, if he could find her out here. Out here, where everything is so much brighter and clearer and vanishing.
Disappearance by David Helwig. Featured in the cast were Jeffrey Bowes as Roger and Susan Hogan as Linda, with Doris Petrie as Roger's mother Lois and Sean McCann as his boss Jerry. You also heard Elva Mae Hoover, Francine Volker, John Stalker, and Ray Landry in a variety of roles. Technical operations were by John McCarthy, with sound effects by Stephanie McKenna, and the production assistant was Nancy McElveen. Original music was composed and arranged by John Roby. The casting consultant was Anne Tate, with Catherine Castor. The series script editor for Vanishing Point is Sandra Rabinovich. The voice of introduction is David Calderisi, and the original musical theme for the series is by John Roby. Disappearance was produced at Studio G in Toronto by series executive producer William Lane.